Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educate.tv and today we are going to test this color OLED display with Arduino. Without any further delay, let's get started. A few weeks ago I discovered this promising new display on banggood.com and I thought that it might be useful in some of our projects, so I bought it right away. It is a color OLED display. I have used this small monochrome OLED display in some of my previous projects and I love it, so I couldn't resist having a color OLED display. I have loaded a demo sketch and as you can see the display is fast and bright. It is brighter than LCD displays because it uses the OLED technology and of course it uses less power. The power usage will vary with how many pixels are lit. The maximum is around 25 milliamps. The cost of this color OLED display is around $11. You can find a link for it in the description of the video. Let's now see more information about this display. The display is very small. It has almost the same size as the monochrome OLED display, but the resolution of it is not the same. It has a resolution of 96 by 64 pixels, so it has a lower resolution at the same size. It can display 65,000 colors. The display I bought uses the SPI interface, so we have to connect 5 pins in order to make it work. The monochrome ones that I have bought use the I2C interface, which requires only 4 pins. So we need more wires in order to connect it with Arduino. Let's see how to achieve that. I am going to connect the color OLED display to an Arduino Uno. Ground pin goes to Arduino ground. VCC pin goes to either 3.3 volts or 5 volt output of the Arduino Uno. I connect it to the 3.3 volt output of the Arduino Uno. The next pin of the display is named SEL, which is a mistake. It is actually clock pin of the SPI interface. So clock pin goes to digital pin 13 of the Arduino Uno. The next pin is also labeled wrong. It is named SDA, but it is actually MOSI pin of the SPI interface. So the fourth pin of the display goes to digital pin 11. The next pin is reset, which goes to digital pin 9. The sixth pin is DC, which goes to digital pin 8. The last pin is CS, which goes to digital pin 10. That's it. We have connected the display to the hardware SPI pins of the Arduino Uno board. This way we can achieve the best performance possible. Let's now power up the board to see if everything works okay. As you can see, the display works fine and the demo sketch is running. Let's now see the software side of the project. The display uses the SSD1331 driver, so in order to make it work with Arduino, we need to download the SSD1331 Adafruit library. From the IDE, go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries and search for the Adafruit SSD1331 library. You also need the Adafruit GFX library. If you haven't already installed the GFX library, search for it and download it as well. Install both libraries and you are ready to use the display. It's that easy. We then have to go to File, Examples, Adafruit SSD1331 and load the test sketch. We press Upload and the sketch will start running. If we take a look at the code of the sketch, we can see that drawing text and graphics on the display is very easy with the provided functions. That's another advantage of this display, the excellent library support. As you can see, it is very easy to use this color OLED display with Arduino. Since we use our familiar Adafruit GFX library with this display, we can easily develop sketches with it. You can find the code for this simple sketch I have developed in the description of the video. I have also started working on a simple Pong game using this display. I will post a video when ready. I really like this display. I think it will be my choice for small handheld projects. I would love to hear your opinion about this display. What kind of projects do you want to build with it? Please post any comments or ideas in the comment section below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.